is present. Okay. I think it's conscientious. A spare.
See anything you like? Feel free to take a look around. We got a pretty good selection.
Stock. Perfect. Starfarer.
All right, your ship's all ready for you.
Let's hope the elevator works. Yes. Yeah. Flashlight doesn't work. That was a hole. Set at Grim Hex.
Hello. How can MISC help you today? Systems.
Myself enough room to get out.
Landing gear down.
Just in time. If we go here. Now that's toward Levski. Other way.
Quantum travel engaged.
Beautiful. Beautiful. give myself the shortest walk possible.
And incomplete. Have a pleasant stay.
Still can't use my flashlight. I am dumb. Stand clear. Something. Freelancer. So, Olisar to Grim. What have we got? Still waste. Good. Graham to Olisar. Nothing. All right, so waste to Graham. Scrap to Levski. Still no flashlight. It's obstructed, isn't it? Shoot.
Engines off. Engines on. Launch sequence complete. Landing gear up.
Oh no, we're good. Let's see. Not quite.
Quantum travel engaged. Quantum travel complete.
Is here.
Landing gear down.
There we are. Thank you. kiosks are this way. I remember that. Buy some armor. I don't remember where that is. Clothing. Is this all I have? Don't know my way around very well. Yeah, there we go. I want this. Can I have some money to make back? I forgot what that. Super goofy. ABM. Unfortunately, this is not 3.2. This is still 3.14. I am not one of the lucky evocati. Don't want to do this because the field of view is horrible. I'm going to switch back. Oops. Yeah, there we go. That looks a little better. Full field of view. Lovely. And it looks okay. Who am I kidding? I look super goofy. But that's alright. To the task at hand. Oh, gotcha, yeah. This is the, that was the armory at Grim Hex. And don't worry about it at all. There's still so much of this game that, heck, I am unfamiliar. fingers crossed for 3.2. Maybe on Friday I'll book another person. Wave again. There we go. Downstairs. Are you planning to get the game? Do you have it already? Are you waiting to see what bugs there are in 3.2 before committing? There was. There.
Launch sequence complete. Landing gear up.
Now. Let's just quantum travel straight through the asteroids. Didn't work. Not dangerous at all. No problem. We're experts. Yeah. We are experts. Well, you are in luck. It will be a very long time before the game officially releases, so plenty of time to get your PC up to spec. And I do not know what the effective minimum specs are. I don't think CIG has provided those, but someone has done some testing. It's like an i7. That's why you said it that way. Very good, very good. Something like an i7 and a 960 and 16 gigs of RAM, I think. Not insignificant. All right, I've been practicing my half jumps, so let's see how this goes. That was all right. Shabby. I'm sure a professional could jump toward OM1 and get right on top of Levski, but I am not a professional. Working on it. I'm trying. God, This game is so pretty. When it works, it really works. Uh-oh. That turret doesn't have any guns on it. Well, crap. I don't think I did that. I probably did do that. I'm a Dumbo. I'm kind of a Dumbo. We're almost there. Almost there. Gonna try not to be too brash with this approach. I'm used to flying the Starfarer here and having to be overly cautious. Absolutely right. Yep, he can be in the same ship as someone and do something completely different. I think turret improvements are coming in 3-2, so the advantage of having additional crew members will be more significant. I'm so bad at flying in atmosphere. Every time that guy picks up, something explodes. Unfortunately, this game will not be coming to consoles. I know Chris Roberts has stated he is adamantly PC Master Race. Oops, crunch. We're fine. No problem. No problem at all.
There you go. Safely landed.
This, oh, what is wrong with my... Oh, right. I have really heavy armor. This is Levski, which is the landing area on Delamar. And it's... Yeah, this is Levski. It is way out there. And extremely buggy. I'll be happy to get a working elevator. That's always the concern right off the bat. Press the button and pray. Still no flashlight. This one might be broken. I think think that one's broken. Crap. Well, I know a few tricks to get a different landing pad. By Revere. 07 Revere, how are you? Thank you very much for the raid. Howdy, getting ghosts. How are you doing? BM, thank you for the follow. I hope you had a good stream. I saw you on a while ago.
All right. Your ship's all ready for
excuse
you.
Excuse me. But I was eating dinner and doing some chores and what have you. Great, glad to hear it. I need to check out one of your streams. Because I saw your name in the Altama Discord, and I've seen you in everybody's chat, and I have no idea what you like to do, how you play this game, and all that good stuff. And I feel negligent. So I apologize. That's not what I wanted. Call Vic again.
And there. Hangar assigned.
Ah. Good. Different hangar. Cargo, cargo, cargo. With a slash of jazz. That'd be like, I hope this guy doesn't commandeer my spot. A slash of jazz would be like, oops. Classical jazz meets Kiss. Oh, you know, I did stop by one day and I remember your jazz. It is a nice touch. Clunk. Engine's off. Engines off.
And done. Welcome to Levski.
Thank you, Vic, for the warm welcome. Man, my eye is itchy. Well, welcome everyone who is here. I am a new member of Altama. I do some cargo running and some scavenging primarily, and a lot of trying to get Levski to cooperate. So, something for everybody. If anyone is an elevator technician, Levski could use someone. They could really use some help. Oh gosh, I Where are my manners? Didn't even introduce myself. I am Shy Canadian, but you can call me Danny, because that is my name and that's what I am used to responding to. And I can be, gosh, this armor is now in the way. I can be pretty, oh my, holy cow, absent-minded at times. Jesus. There. Now, bye. Freelancer, iodine. All the iodine. Sorry. This armor may end up not working for me. Oh man, I love this glitch. Sometimes people with mohawks get their mohawks to show through their helmets, and it makes me very happy. And I apologize for the ridiculous way I take screenshots. I'm too lazy to change it. So how's everyone doing this fine evening? It is the graveyard shift. Am I a freelancer, or am I creating an org, joining an org, waiting? Admiral, I have joined a few orgs. My primary is Altama. Mentorship, there we go. Which is for, it's an energy supply company. So things like hydrogen and whatnot. But I also really like scavenging, which I will probably do on my own predominantly. I did pick up a vulture for that purpose. Freelancer takeoff is so janky. Kusunagi, Admiral Kusunagi. Are you actively searching for an organization? Excuse me. I am so phlegmy. Okay. I'm gonna have to jump around Delamar a little bit. Getting ghosts. You can hear me now. No other way around. Sorry, I've already forgotten what I said. Are you creating an org? And actively recruiting, I guess. Where the heck am I going? Well, this'll work. Uh-oh, getting ghosts, you were having audio issues. Well, dang, you just can't catch a break, can you? Glad your audio issues are resolved. It seems like, especially with Windows, those can... audio issues can create themselves with no warning whatsoever. Like, wow, that was a painstakingly complex audio setup you had going. It would be a shame if something happened to it. Kusanagi, you have a small org at the moment. Don't usually hit people up on streams. You were flying with her VR a second ago. Have another member of your org who streams. Try to help him out. Well, cool. Yeah, I've been streaming, I guess, for a couple weeks at the community. The Star Citizen community and the streaming community are really awesome. Getting Ghost, you got your HOTAS dialed in for better heavy-handedness. That just means a firm grasp on the controls and not any sort of glitch-induced rage. There we go. Goodbye, Delamar. Ah, oh, shoot. I did it dumb, didn't I? Yeah. Now, where the heck is... Portal Azar?
Contact received.
Admiral Kusanagi, I have no idea why I'm missing guns. I noticed that maybe at Grim Hex, not a clue where they went. I did not remove them, I don't think. Yeah, just, no guns. I do want to, I think I'll claim this ship. That should put the guns back. But, Kusanagi, what kind of, what do you want the focus of your organization to be? Does it not have one? I know some do a little of everything.
Landing gear down.
All right, let's call Vic's cousin. We'll call him Kev. Vic's cousin Kev. What's going on over there? BM, some streamer said PTU is out? Oh my gosh. Well. Mining and cargo. Trying not to do everything. Because that's not a great business decision. So you'll do careers that support cargo and mining, which makes sense. Get that vertical integration going on. Okay. Let me go sell my stuff. I know there's not much point because it's all going to disappear. ETU is out. We will close this chapter of Star Citizen on a happy note. Filthy, stinking rich. That's a happy note, right? Bonk. God, this damn armor. Just parked your Connie next to the whacked out ship. Well, Admiral, let me come wave to you at least. Or salute. I guess if you're an Admiral, you probably need a salute, don't you? Side. Let's see. Oh, already logged out. Well, now I can take a glance at this poor thing. Boy. All right, well, let's see if we can this is what I need to do. Okay, we will close that. I am in the mountain time zone, Admiral. Kill some things. Oh, task manager's over here. Aww. Well, man, you're Eastern. Gotcha. Yeah. It's pretty late for you. It's pretty late for me too, but I'm a fool, so I stay up and stream late into the night. I guess I don't have 3-2 yet, which is a shame, but one day, eventually. But Admiral, thank you for stopping by and chatting for a bit. I always appreciate company. I hope your organization goes well. I know that can be a lot of work, so good luck and Come say hi again sometime. Admiral, for the follow. Fortunately, I'm not in charge of my orc, but we do appreciate the support. You take care as well. Have a good one. So does PTU come out in waves? Is it like first backers get it first, or I guess subscribers, and then the first backers, and then the second wave of backers? Is that how they do it? Does anybody know? I feel like I should know this. I do not. As it looks, I think I'm going to switch my helmet back. Maybe. Not in this room, I guess. Weird. Backers and CIG subscribers first. That looks silly as hell. Jeez. That railgun is absolutely ridiculous. Oh, but my flashlight works again. I completely forgot. BM, I'm sorry, this is not, it's not 3.2. But I am extremely excited to play it whenever it does make it to my computer. It's a blank slate where we get lots of new toys, and there are plenty of fun new bugs to find. Ah, crap. This only lets me carry one gun. I forgot. Dang it. Alright. Fine game, you got me. Defiance weapons. Nice, it kept all the... kept all that stuff. So ridiculous. So dang ridiculous. I don't even care. Make sure nobody followed me. Out of the way. We are bouncing. That's not good. Close the door. Close the door. Someone ran into me. Well, we made it now. You don't have the game yet, so just watching. Watching people stream is cool. And honestly, that's what, that's kind of what got me hooked on the game in the first place, was the hangar module way back in, like, I don't even know when that was. But it was like, hey, here's a spaceship. Your own spaceship, and you can walk around it. Like, it wasn't much, but it was super awesome. Oops. Phooey. I don't remember the button. Hold on. Just gonna have to mouse it. There we go.
Contact received.
Really, the CIG is like putting their heart and soul into making this a super accurate, more or less, space sim. And like, they've done an awesome job so far. And all the new stuff they have planned on the pipeline is... it's awesome. It's super, super exciting.
Quantum travel engaged.
It's like they're bored of all the space sims that aren't this detailed or something. So, heck, they made their own. Is there a ship you've been looking at in particular? The one you think you'd like to start with? I'm just gonna fly to Levski rather than wait to jump around a whole bunch. So this will be a chill little cruise. Probably won't ever come out on console. I don't know that current gen consoles could handle it, even. It's not super optimized. It's not optimized at all. I shouldn't even say otherwise, but it's a big game. There's so much going on. so nice. Heavily dangerous, yeah. But you can't move around in your ship. Well, at least from my experience, like transitioning from inside your ship to outside your ship is one of the trickier parts of the game, especially in EVA, because all the ships have internal gravity, so you go from zero gravity to suddenly gravity, and the game has to figure out how to get you from floating to walking. And it's not always pretty. Gingo says console with keyboard on the gamepads. Okay. So like a PC is a console. But instead of a controller, you've got keyboard mouse. I should probably start slowing down. Starfare. Oh, my back end is still sparking because I ran into something. Out there. All right. Got to atmosphere. Start slowing down. I'm speeding up. Stop watching videos about the Constellation Andromeda. The Constellation was one of the first ships that they showed for the game, I think, and it was, I guess it was kind of the flagship. It's, the Constellation is a really good ship. It's not, I didn't enjoy it much for solo play. If you've got a crew in it, it's really solid. It's got good weaponry, good engines, good cargo space. A few of the models have the snub fighter in the back. It does a lot of stuff. CIG does, they do a really good job with their advertising for the ships, like making it pretty authentic, seem like a real commercial, like for an actual vehicle. I think I'm gonna overshoot this again. Mass Effect. Okay. Time for some aggressive maneuvers here. The ship alone almost makes you want to buy the game. There's a starter pack with a Connie in it. So many buttons. Why does it have six pedals when there are only four directions? Andromeda, okay. So there's a Constellation Andromeda starter pack for $275, which is not cheap. But yeah, BM the Avenger. I have not flown an Avenger, so you probably shouldn't take my word on it, but I see a lot of them. It seems like a good ship. It seems like a versatile ship. It can do a little bit of cargo. It's got pretty good weaponry. Gotta call Vic. Massive and unwieldy. Insert yo mama joke here. Good landing gear's down. So hard to line this thing up sometimes. And if anybody has a Starfarer and spawns it at Levski or retrieves it, it will spawn too far back in the hangar. So you need to move forward a little bit before you try and get out of the hangar, otherwise you'll clip your tail, which is why the back of mine is smoking or sparking. Clunk.
Landing complete. Have a pleasant stay.
Just the landing at Levski gives you a boner. other things at Levski will quickly make your Bonner disappear, like the elevators, which sometimes work and often do not. But it's a cool game. It is a really cool game. Stay away from the door while it's opening, or it gets stuck. Levski just likes Stargate. Hope this elevator works. Oh, please, please, Levski. Oh my goodness, it's Christmas. It is Christmas at Levski. Time the elevator works. Or confetti should pop out somewhere. But presumably that's fixed in 3-2, so much for the confetti. We'll just have to find another glitch to use the confetti for. This is gonna be so annoying. How much money they just gave me for poop. Buy iodine. Tons of iodine. 10 and change. How many people can be in the Starfarer? It is massive. I think. Oh crap, I forgot which hangar. The cockpit has 5 seats, I think. That includes, like, the captain's chair. I guess it's pilot, co-pilot, captain, navigator, somebody else, scanner, maybe. So I think it has 5 cockpit seats. Server of 50 people, so pack the other 45 in there if you really want to. They'd have to stand in the cargo bay or something, but did anyone follow me in here? No. Good. No, there's a contract. Let's see if it's available right now. Contract. No, there's one that'll show up called Investigation. And one of the investigations is to go to a crashed, a derelict Starfarer and locate the bodies of the crew. And for that, I think there are 8 or 10 that you have to find, maybe. So there's like there's someone who stands here and controls the cargo, or I think there's one who's like the oil refiner. There's maybe a gunner, so it can hold a lot of people. I'm not sure if the other seats in the cockpit have much of a job right now, like how effective they can be, but the chairs work. Look at that. Look at the shadow as the doors open. Gorgeous. Freaking gorgeous. I did turn my engines on, right? Was stuck before. All right, so let's get clear so someone else can have that pad since the elevator works. Don't want to hog that commodity. It's pretty freaking sweet. Like, there's this turret up top. I would point at it, but I can't point at the screen. And then there are actually two right here on the back behind the fuel canisters. So you could put a gunner in each of those as well. I don't know how many ships I have. Maybe 6 or 7? No, it's more than that. Maybe more like 10, but I only use a couple of them frequently. Starfarer is my big cargo hauler. Freelancer is good for medium cargo and exploration kind of stuff. Man, I'm sorry, but this is just going to take a hot minute. This isn't the space turtle because it's fast. It's the space turtle because if you flip it on its back, it's almost impossible to get back the right way up. Which is my favorite? At this point, probably the Freelancer. It's an excellent, versatile ship for a solo player. It can be a multi-crew ship. It's got a turret, it's got a co-pilot seat, but it works fine solo. The Reliant is also a lot of fun. Accelerating at almost the same rate, whether I boost or not. Yeah, it's like exactly the same. So I can just take in the scenery. The Reliant Core is out right now, and it's a really cool ship, in my opinion. It's a little bit useless. The guns aren't that great. The cargo space is kind of lacking. It's passably fast, passively maneuverable. But it's a really cool ship. It's like this, I don't know if you've seen the Reliant, but it's like a big wedge kind of. And the cockpit and the cargo hold cargo hold stays flat, the cockpit and the wing rotate like that when it goes from landing mode to flight mode. It's such a cool looking little ship. I realize it's gimmicky, but it's very cool. Uh-oh, I'm slowing down. Shallower angle. There we go. We're in space. We're fine. Apparently the edge of the atmosphere is just tricky. PM, what kind of gameplay do you like? Do you like dogfighting? Do you like cargo? Bounty hunting. Because there's, at this point, there's almost a ship for whatever you want to do. Oh. Going right through the asteroid like it ain't no thing. What's up with this Port Olisar Fight Club? That one's not having a good time. That one's having a really bad time. Local security or something. Let's call Vic. Oh, look, another Vic.
Proceed to assigned landing bay.
Exit in the nose of this ship. If you're an EVA, you can get back in, but if there's gravity, you can't. Well, maybe you could. Once the ship gravity kicks in, it might not work. I guess I should park over this way. That may be a little too close there. Always come down too hard. Oops. Ship lights, engines, power. Yeah, five seats in here. What's a seat. It's this one. Also just a seat. That cargo capacity. Fantastic. Oh, wait. I didn't want to let that person in. Quick, get back to the cockpit. Oh, there's a reclaimer over there. All right. Where is the close? Now, I assume that guy is still in here somewhere. Can't get the camera any closer than that, though. Is he right behind me? Yeah, the Reliant looks really cool. It just doesn't do a whole lot right now. You know what I might be able to do to keep my ship here? Let's flip it upside down. I guess this works better in space, and now I have no idea how to get out, but we can confuse the heck out of this guy, maybe. Oh, no, I see. Gravity's always down. Well, I guess he's just gonna have to get bored and leave. Or I can block the pad until I make my ship get stored. Or I know. I'll just take someone else's pad. Just take the crime stat. If I'd remembered to drop out the front, this wouldn't have been a problem. Thank you. going? Where is he going? I want to steal the ship. Sucks, dude. I can take advantage of weird game mechanics too. Ha. Suck my butt. Clunk. Yep, there he is. I'm just gonna sit here and block this landing pad. Into the damn cockpit. Look, Olisar, I'm parked illegally. Just take my ship, would ya? Both sides are broken. Huh. Maybe I'm wearing out the engines or something. He's still walking around. Hello. Different illegal landing pad. Engines, there we go. Man, this guy's being such a pain in the ass. Not making Vic mad. So I may have to go. Over this way. And park on the Sorry, this is not the most exciting thing in the world. I have a lot of cargo in here, and I don't want it stolen by some asshole at Olisar. So, gonna do what I gotta do. Sorry, Reclaimer, you probably want no part in this. It still hasn't left. Man, how hard is it not to have someone steal your ship? Like, seriously. Why is this a thing? Why do people insist upon being assholes? Too much. To get mad at me and forcefully storm my ship. Maybe it doesn't work with someone else on it. That doesn't make a whole lot of sense. Oh, almost hit somebody there. I have an idea. I have a... whoops. Sometimes the buttons don't work. Has just been released. Okay. Well, Admiral Kusanagi, thank you for letting me know. I will check again. And in fact, I did want to exit out of the game shortly.
Please proceed to assigned landing bay.
Yeah, thank you for letting me know. Really shouldn't stay up all night playing it, even if it has been released, but... oh, check email. Good call. Good call. I should not have opened Chrome. Sorry, CPU. Forgive me. Clunk.
Landing complete. Have a pleasant stay.
All right. Landing complete. Power off. Thank you so much, Admiral Kusanagi. And getting ghosts. Oh, right. Copy account to PTU thing. forgot that there's a separate launcher. Aha, I still have the thing in there for the PTU-25 launcher. BM, it will depend on how long the download takes. I've got pretty decent internet, but I don't want to. I don't want to be up until like 1 in the morning, and I don't want to sit here with nothing happening on the stream for you folks. So you don't need that. Don't need that crap from me. Let's see. Wait. See if this works. Oh, install. There we go. Okay. Says I'm gonna guess at 5 to 10 minutes left. Probably doesn't help that I'm streaming at the same time, but that is a risk I'm willing to take. In the words of the great Lord Farquaad. I think I have money for a cutlass. I would like a cutlass. No, I don't. I don't have anything to melt. Well, I guess. So what do we do while we're waiting? Is there anything exciting? RSI. There's calling all devs. This might be uncouth, but I have not watched this yet.
Hey everybody, welcome to another episode of Calling All Devs, the weekly Q&A series where I take questions from you, the Star Citizen community, and pose them directly to our backers, usually, backers, jeez, our developers, usually on Skype. One take, Huckabee. All right. On the show this week, we are going straight to director of Star Citizen Live, Todd Pappy, in our Foundry 42 office. I got a couple questions for him I think he'll be perfect for. Todd, how you doing, man?
Hey, Jared.
Welcome back to Calling All Devs.
Thank you.
All right, I got some questions for you. Some oldies, some newies. Right off the bat, let's just get to it because people say I talk too much. First question, will it be possible from the Mobi Glass to remotely control our ship or to trigger an autopilot that will pick us up from our position?
No, we haven't talked about them.
All right, easy peasy. Let's get to one a little harder. With ship item kiosks coming in Alpha 3.2, can we expect a ship buying or renting experience in the Persistent Universe anytime soon?
Yes, so that team is currently slated to tackle...
That is so exciting.
Arena Commander and getting Star Marine, the front end, and getting the wreck working in there. We'll also be able to take the tech to put it into the Persistent Universe. So one of the goals is to get a shop in Hurston working. So for Arena Commander and Star Marine, that will be using the wreck. For Hurston, that will be using AUEC.
Awesome. And this, of course, takes the place of the current electronic access store that's available on the robertspaceindustries.com website.
Correct. Yeah. It's to ease that user experience and get as much stuff in-game as possible.
All right. Well, that sounds good. Let me just reiterate, make sure. You said targeting Star Marine and Arena Commander for 3-3 and Hurston... possibly 3-3, possibly 3-4.
Well, it's we're aiming for 3-3.
Okay.
So I think there's going to be some issues that we'll run into, but we're aiming for 3-3, and that's what we're going to try our best to hit.
Fair enough, man. All right, I'll let you get back to work.
Cool.
All right, thank you.
Take care.
Halfway done with the
download. So much. Up next, we're going to a Calling All Devs newbie.
Five more minutes.
Ben Parr at a Foundry 42 UK. We got a question about the Genesis Starliner that I think he's perfect to ask for. Ben, how you doing, man?
How you doing?
I'm doing well. Welcome to Calling All Devs, man. First time.
Thank you. First time.
You're not a person that's usually on camera. Just real quick, 10-cent version. What do you do for Star Citizen?
I am a associate producer. I currently oversee the VFX team, the concept art teams, the props team. I dabble in ships, and I mostly deal with ship concepts.
Awesome. So we've got a question about the Genesis Starliner that was voted up. Recently, we revealed the Hercules Starlifter from Crusader Industries. I think that's probably built a lot of interest in Crusader Industries and the only other ship we've ever revealed, the Genesis Starliner, way back in 2015. Because I was surprised to see this question voted up, but it was. So the question was just simply...
The base pack that it says is downloading was something like 12 gigs. So it's most of the way there.
What's the deal with the Genesis Starliner?
What's the deal? You know, we try and match ship's priorities with the needs of each release. And while there's a schedule in place right now, when we plan out future releases, those priorities may change. The roadmap is on the website. It's not listed right now, so don't expect it in the next year or so. But I can't give you an actual release on that ship, unfortunately.
Right. You know, in the years past, we developed ships as we had resources for them, as we, you know, even you had the right mix of artists in the ships, like, okay, put them on there. Squadron 42 needs were a big priority for some ships, like the reason the Avenger got reworked recently, because it's need for Squadron 42. The Starliner, which is a ship that's special to me, because it was the very first concept promotion that I got to work on myself when I hired in. Doesn't really have a driving need in the Persistent Universe right now, so it's not being prioritized.
Yeah,
but
I don't remember exactly what it is.
Right there on ship, it's like, it's happening, because for all you people that are like, give me the Carrick and give me the Benny Merchantman, I'm the only guy out there. It's like, give me the Starliner.
So, I'm sure you'll be over the moon when it's finally announced for its release as well.
Oh, that's all I'm going to do in game. People are always like, just go to do a game. I'm just going to fly around picking people up. Just like, you know, when you get into a Starliner, you got a 50-50 chance that it's going to be Disco piloting it, because there's only like a small handful of them in the universe. All right, Ben, I will let you get back to work. Thank you so much, dude.
Thank you very much, Jared. All right. See you next time. Bye-bye.
All right, and up next, we go to Austin, Texas, and our very own Calling All Devs All-Star, Mr. Rob Reiniger. We've got a question about insurance. Rob, how you doing, man?
Yes, sir, I'm doing pretty good. How you doing, Jared?
And, you know, it's another day in paradise. It's my stock answer. I have no other answer to that. Yeah. All right, so insurance. If there's one topic that has pervaded Star Citizen as a project since the very beginning, it's questions about insurance. We've got one for you here. It says, how is insurance time going to be calculated? Is it actual hours played, or is it like a 24-hour clock that starts every time that you log in, like the rec times have been? Or is it 1 year? Was 1 year 365 days in real time? What's our thinking about how this is going to work?
Insurance times, as far as I understand it, are going to be based on real world, months, days, weeks. We have other things, like rent a habitation unit for a week, a month, a year, and discounts for those various, amount of time. So insurance is going to be very similar, much like we're trying to implement loading times for cargo and, refueling times. Like these are going to be things that are something like, cause it'd be weird to see a timer going down super fast just because the game time is actually sped up to help, allow people to see different day and night cycles. So it's all timers, as far as I understand, are going to be game or real time.
Yeah.
So that it's easily understandable, it's consistent across the game, and players, if they go on vacation for a week, won't get kind of screwed out of some of their time just because they're happen to be out of town. So.
Yeah. Yeah, this is one of those questions.
This mining looks exciting.
One of the common challenges of picking these questions for Calling All Devs.
Well, I've got another 32 gigs on this download, so I think I'll call it a night for the stream so that you don't have to sit here and wait for this, but you can be sure that anyone who has this tomorrow... No, I'm not sure. I haven't read that far in the patch notes. I don't know if we can get to Hurston. It might be too far away from Crusader. Okay, it looks like we can get more. Okay, weaponry at Dumper's Depot. Nice. Purchase and equip from a single interface. Yeah, I'm gonna call it a night and either let this finish off stream or finish it in the morning, but I'll be streaming again tomorrow morning. That'll be like 8:30 mountain time, probably. 8 or 8:30 mountain time. Or I'm sure you can find lots of other folks with 3.2. Let's see if there's anyone right now. Star Citizen. Holy cow, there are a lot of people playing 3.2. Sredny is on. Okay. I'm gonna take us all. Not very many of us, but. I'm not sure about. Off the top of my head, I don't know what the plan was for Hurston. Okay, this is a nice fix or change. So Hurston is coming in 3-3. Hurston, Lorville, Hurston Moons, and a small rest stop. So that's 3-3. Unfortunately not in 3-2. Alright, but I'm gonna take us over to Sredny's stream. He's been in my stream a few times, so I'm quite happy to support him in return. Thank you everyone for hanging out, for watching and chatting, and I'll be on tomorrow at 8:30 Mountain Time, which is 10:30 Eastern, 7:30 West Coast time. But have a good night, and or day, or whatever time it is for you. And I hope to catch you around the verse. See you next time, BM. Thanks for hanging out. I hope Star Citizen catches.